Hello all. Now we will see example of two pass assembler in details. Here in this example we are going to consider some hypothetical instructions. So here you can see mod table. Mod table are having some imperative statements like move r, move am, add, sub, multiplication, division, print, read, bc. And in pot these are the assembly directive statement which are giving the direction to assembler. That's why it is known as assembly directive statement. Example, start, end, origin, equivalent, LT origin. And these are the registers which we are going to consider for this example. Now this is a source code which are having some instructions which is not having any meaning for this source code. Just we are going to learn how to convert this assembly program into machine code. Okay, so in two pass assembler these are the data structures: symbol table, literal table and pool table. So symbol table is having data structure symbol number, symbol name and address, and literal table literal number, name and address. So output of a pass one of two pass assembler will be intermediate code which we are going to convert. Then symbol table will be generated and literal table will be generated. Now we will see how to generate intermediate code using this source code, source program. Now we will start with first instruction. So first instruction is start 200. Okay, so start 200 is a assembly directive statement. So start is a assembly directive statement and which whose position is 01 in pot table. Okay, now operand of start is 200. Sometime it is blank, that means start only. So this 200 is nothing but location counter, starting address of your program. If it is blank, then location counter will be 0. So location counter is nothing but LC. Okay, so this instruction we will write intermediate code for this start is nothing but assembly directive, position in pot table is 0. Now first operand is not present, so dash, and C means constant which is 200. So using this first instruction we are going to do LC processing. So next instruction onward our LC will be 200. Okay, now next instruction is move R AREGA. So move R AREGA, move R is a imperative statement. So first instruction is an imperative statement, position in mod is 01, in this way we will write. Then second token we can say is a AREG, which is a register again which is present at first position in register table. So we will write 01 for this, and A is nothing but symbol. These are the symbol A, B, X, these are the symbol, and literals is equal to 5, is equal to 15, like that. These are the literals or constants. Okay, so now we will represent symbols with the help of capital S and literals with capital L. Okay, and this C stands for capital means constant. Okay, so S stands for symbol. Now we will store this information in symbol table. Right now first we will search whether this A is already present in symbol table. If this is not present, then we will add that symbol as a new symbol in symbol table, which is a A. So this is a A whose position is one position in symbol table. In this way this is our intermediate code for this statement. Now next statement we will increment location counter to 201, then add BREGB. Okay, before that this is a label. So label is nothing but our symbol. So we will add label in symbol table whose name is label L1, and we will give current LC to the L1. So current LC is 201, so we will give that address. Now this instruction add BREGB, so add is the imperative statement, position in add is 03, then BREG is 02 in register table. Now B is a new symbol, so we will add that symbol at next location, which is 03. So at 03 position we will add this B as a symbol. Okay, now next is a 202. print B. Now again print is an imperative statement which is present at 7th position in mod table. Okay, you can see here. Then first operand is not present. So B. Now B is a symbol now which is already present in symbol table. So we will directly get that position from symbol table. Okay. Now these all symbols are not having any addresses. All symbols will get addresses after DC and DS statement. Okay, we'll see it later. Now next instruction, increment location counter to 203. Next instruction is imperative statement, which is a read at 08 position in mod, then dash. Now it is a is equal to 5, which is a literal. So we will represent this L stands for literal. Whether this is equal to 1 is present in literal table? No. So we will add that literal in literal table at position 1, 0. So we will add this 0, 1. Now here LTORG is the statement, assembly directive statement, which are used to give addresses to literals. So if there is a literal, right now you can see in this program here LTORG is present. So before this is a pool 1, then this is a pool 2 up to this literal LTORG statement, and this will our pool 3. Means after LTORG statement we are going to assign addresses to literal. So that's why these are the pool 1, then this one is 2, and this is the third pool. Okay, so we will store that information in pool tab. So initially our pool number is 0, 1. Okay, now next instruction is a read instruction. Okay, read instruction is done. Now next instruction is print instruction, whose number is LC is 204. Imperative statement, print is present at 07. Then this is dash again L. This is a literal is equal to 15, which is not present here. So we will add that literal in literal table at second position. Okay. Now here LTORG. LTORG, after LTORG statement, we are going to assign addresses to literals. So how many literals are there in literal table? 2 literals. So these 2 literals will get the addresses. So from which location? From 01 to current position of literal count. Means from 01 to 02 we will give the addresses. Okay. Means for is equal to 5 and is equal to 15 we will give the address. So imperative statement. Now LTORG is a assembly directive statement which is present at 5th position in our pod. Then to whom we are going to give address is equal to 5. So we will write in this way. For 5 we are going to give address, which is 205, which is a current LC. Okay. Now one more literal is there, which is a is equal to 15. So increment 206, which is again assembly directive, means using this LTORG we are going to give address to is equal to 15. Okay, so next is a 206. This address we will assign to is equal to 15. Understood? Now next is 207, increment location counter with 207. So multiplication. So multiplication is a imperative statement, multiplication at 05 position. CREG is 03 and X is a new symbol. So we will store that new symbol X in symbol table at position 4. So this is a 4 position. Now next is a 208. Again imperative statement, imperative statement 04. Then BREG is 2 and is equal to 5. Now here is equal to 5, which is already present in first pool. Now is equal to 5, this is in second pool. So we will add it again. Okay. And here in pool tab, we will give the current position of LC. Literal. Okay. So from 3 onward, we will assign the addresses to literal. Okay. So BREG 02. So is equal to 5 L03. Is equal to 5 L03. Now next 209. Again imperative statement, division, which is at 6th position. CREG 03. New symbol, that is a loop. So S loop we will add at next position, because loop is not present in symbol table, so we will add at next position 5. Okay, now next is 210 loop. Here loop is a label, so we will give current address to the loop 210. Okay, now store x is a imperative statement. Now store is not present in our mod, so right now we will add that in our instruction at 10th position. So 10th position, so store x dash x is already present in symbol table at which position 04. Okay, now next, this is done. Now origin, using origin we are going to reset our assembler with new location counter. Means this will be our new location counter, L1 plus 30. Our L1 is having 201 address plus 30, means next instruction will have 231 address. Okay, so for origin and for equivalent statement we are not going to generate any intermediate code. Okay, so there won't be any intermediate code. Now next statement is ADS3, so next location counter will be 213. Okay, so using DS and DC statement we are going to assign addresses to this AXB, means symbols. Okay, so using this statement we are going to give address to ADS3, so current address will be 231, which we will give to A, 231. So how we can write intermediate code for this? DS is a, here we will DS, we will give first position and second position. Okay, DS and DC, these are the declarative statements. Okay, so declarative statements we will represent in this way. Okay, DL, so DL in DL which is present at 01 position. Okay, so 01. Now which we have given number 3. What is meaning of this one? ADS3 means we are going to assign memory for 3 bytes. This is a DS. Okay, and DC means we are going to assign constant to that number, means A will have these 3 locations, and this XDC2 means X will have 2 as a constant number. Okay, so DL01-0003. In this way we will write the intermediate code. Now next statement is a LTORG statement. Again this is a LTORG statement, means we are going to give the addresses to literals, so increment our location counter. Now this is a DS statement, so location counter will increment by 3, so next instruction will have 234 as a location counter. This is the difference in between DS and DC. Okay, now using LTORG we will assign the address 2 is equal to 5. So from 03 to 03 we will give the addresses. So assembly directive LTORG 05, to whom we are going to assign address is equal to 5. So we will write in this way, is equal to 5, we will get the addresses 234. Okay, now next, at location 235, move R, which is the imperative statement, at 01 in mod, then BREG is a register at second position, and X which is already present in our symbol table, so we will write symbol 04. Okay, now next is a 236 location counter. Again using this DC statement we will give the address to X, so this is a declarative constant which is present in second position in DL, so dash, which number we are going to give 2. Okay, so X will have 236 address. Okay, now next is increment 237, because this is a DC statement, so we will increment LC by 1 only. Now DLB, to whom we are going to give address? B. Okay, DL01002, so which address we are going to give? 237. Okay, now next is end instruction, So next instruction will be 239 because this is a DS statement. Now next instruction is a AND statement. So assembly directive AND, which is present at two position 02. So no any literal present. So dash dash. Here dash dash meaning blank. So in this way we will generate intermediate code for source program. Okay. Now we will see how to generate machine code. Here you can see in this example, this DL is used for declarative statement. Okay, declarative statement, and using this we are going to give addresses to symbols. Now how to generate machine code? Okay, so machine code is quite easy. So output of this is, output of this one is, this is intermediate code, symbol table, and this literal table is the output of password. Now machine code, this is the this will be output of pass 2. So no need of source code now. Okay, so here while generating pass 2, we are not going to consider source program. So how we will generate this output? So start from this. Okay, for assembly directive there will be blank, dash meaning blank. Okay, so here nothing will be present. Now next instruction, this is a imperative statement, starting location counter is 200. So here we will take this 01 as it is. 01, this is representing imperative statement number. Which imperative statement or the mod? And this is a register. And now next, this part, for this part S01, but 01 is a symbol A. For this we are going to give address. Which address? 231 address. Okay, now 201, which will have 03, this 0302, then S03 means 237, means from symbol table take third position address. This is the meaning. Then 202, 07 dash S03, again 237, then 03, again 08 dash L01, means from literal table, from first position address is 205. Here you can see. Now next 204, 07 L02. So which position? 02 position, which is having 0206 address. Now next is 205. So 205, these are the assembly directives. So nothing. And to whom we have given address is equal to 5 for this literal. So this is a constant number. Then 206, again this dash dash is equal to 15, means this is a 15 constant. Okay, now next is a 207. So this is a 05 imperative statement, so we'll write 05. 03 register. S04 means fourth position symbol address, that is a 236. Now next is 208, again 04, 02 and L03 is having 237 address. Okay, now next is 209, 0603 and S05 is 210. Okay, now 210 will have 10 dash S04 means 236 from this 204. Now this is nothing. Then next location counter 231, this is a declarative statement, so again we'll write in this way, this is dash dash dash. If it is a DS, means declarative storage, all will be blank. Okay, now 234, this is a, again LTORG, so dash dash, this is assembly directive, na? So it is LTORG dash dash, and this is a constant 005, we will give the number. Now 235, so this is imperative statement 0102 and S04 again 236. 236 next location, this is a declarative constant, so here for this dash, if it is a declarative constant, so we will write which constant, which number we have assigned. Okay, 237, again this is a DS, so all will be blank or the dash. Then 239, okay, so 239 it is end statement, dash, 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 nothing will be there. So in this way, this will be machine code, which is loader will load in, finally loader will load this machine code. And finally, we will get the output. So, intermediate code, symbol table, literal table will be the output of pass 1 and output of pass 2 will be machine code. In this way, we can generate our, we can work out our algorithm for 2-pass assembler. Thank you. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and you can also click on like button and you can write comment so that I will answer if you have any query. Thank you so much.